Hi, today I want to walk you through what it looks like to customize your WordPress theme. Headaches I've found in dealing with WordPress is shopping for hours and hours and hours online for a really great WordPress theme, only to install it and it looks nothing like that original preview or that demo version. And it's very frustrating trying to figure out how to make your WordPress theme look like that amazing example. Today, I'm going to walk you through how to do it. Here we go. Okay, this tutorial is going to be hopefully generic enough that it's going to apply to every one of your situations. The truth is, every theme is totally different. So I'm gonna try to hit on the things that should be the same. Now, there are gonna be, every theme is gonna have its own little variation. So the very first step I wanna tell you to hopefully keep you from spinning your wheels and wasting your time is you'll wanna find your theme's documentation. Every theme out there, whether it's free or premium, which means you paid for it, should have some sort of documentation that's going to help you in this whole process. So if you're using ThemeForest, let's say, so this particular theme here, if you came over here and looked at the themes page to see kind of what all this theme is about, there's an area here that has a support area that you can go into and find details on how to connect with this author, especially this is typically here if you've already purchased this theme. But the spot that you really want to go to is, let's scroll up here for a second and go to my downloads. Move me out of the way here. Go to my downloads. Well, it's not going to let me go to my downloads. Go to my downloads. All right, I'm back. And right here in this spot, let's say this particular one, if you go to this download area here, and you click on it, it allows you to download all the files and documentation, okay? So when you click that, it's gonna take a while, it's gonna download to your desktop. What typically is gonna happen is you're gonna get a zipped file like this, you double click it and it creates a folder like this. When you double click that and open it up, you're gonna see a folder hopefully called documentation or an HTML page called documentation. When you open that up and click on it, it should be able to quickly and easily walk you through literally every step. How to set up your home page, how to install it. So this is the very first thing, how to install it. So if you're struggling with how to even get this theme active on your website, here it is, step by step. And it literally will walk you through how to set up the slideshow on the home page, what all your options are. And some authors even have incredible videos that you can literally sit here, click and watch the whole situation take place and fold in front of you. And or they have great screenshots, just like what we're seeing here. So really, really important to be sure to go search for your theme's documentation, okay? If you're using a free theme, this particular theme, Spacious, has a support tab right here. So clicking on that, I'm able to go see an entire forum area type environment where I can ask questions and see what other people are struggling with and maybe get some questions answered if I'm having a problem with getting this to work and to look like my amazing that amazing demo that they did for us. Another thing you want to do, you're going to follow the instructions how to install it and activate it. But the next thing you want to do is you literally want to walk through every single portion of how they say to customize the theme. And some authors even give you another zipped file that's their demo content. And they'll walk you through how to import that and plug it in. And then with that, your whole theme will begin to switch around and look just like that demo. If you're still struggling, there are a couple of things that nobody typically tells you. And you only learn them by trial and error. That's what I want to walk you through right now. So how to set up your home page. If you don't want all your blog posts to be seen on your very home, on your very first page, your home page, you have to actually tell WordPress to make it be a page that you've created, like a home page or a welcome page. So the way to do that is you'd actually go into your settings area and you go into reading. And right here, front page displays, do you want it to display your latest post or do you want it to display a static page, okay? You have to be sure to make the page first and then come to these settings. So if you do that, then in this drop down, you'll have the option of that page that you made. And in this instance, I called my home page home. I select that and I click Save Changes. Then that allows the website to know to present that page of content instead of all of my posts dynamically listed. Remember, WordPress was created for bloggers, right? Initially, that was the concept. So by default, it puts all your posts on that home page. How to set up your menus. This is another thing some people, some authors forget to walk you through, and you get totally turned around. So we know that in the top of your website up here, this area up here typically that runs across the top or maybe down the side of your website is called, WordPress calls those your menus, right? In order to get to those and to set those up appropriately, they're hiding inside of appearance. So if you go to appearance, go to menus, move myself over here, I'll get myself out of the way here. So you can set up and create a brand new menu. Most of the time, menus aren't even sitting here yet, so you have to click this button right here to create a new menu. And you can name it main menu, top menu, whatever you want to call it, and click this button will actually say create menu. You'll click that. And then now all of your content is sitting over here on the left side. So you can choose whatever pages you want and click add to menu. Whenever you click that, they'll automatically put them over here and you can drag and drop these in whatever order you want these to appear inside that menu. All right? If you don't see all of your content here, click this little button that says view all, and it'll list all of your pages alphabetically here for you to choose from. You can choose those again, click add to menu. They'll drop over here in a random order. You just grab, drag, and drop them in whatever order you want them to be in. If you want them to be a drop down, maybe you want apply today underneath contact us. Slide it just slightly to the right and see how it becomes a submenu. And now you'll have that drop down effect. I don't want to do that. I want these all to be on one line. And just click save menu. And then down at the bottom, check this out right here, theme locations. Now some of your themes might offer different locations here. Your top menu is where I want this particular menu to appear. I want it to appear at the top of my website. So I'm going to check that box and click Save Menus. And now it'll overwrite whatever default option was taking place up there. So super tricky, and a lot of authors forget to mention it to you. So let's set a couple more things. You might have some page templates that apply. This again should be documented in all of that amazing, helpful resource of documentation that your author gives you. But if not, and you say, but this page has a sidebar and I didn't want a sidebar on it, I want it to be full width. You'll go into that page that you want to manipulate. Let's just say this one, about us. And over here on the right side, there are page templates. Now these are going to look a little different, again, depending upon theme to theme to theme, right? But you somewhere on this page, you should have the option to select your page template. And see, I have one that says full width. That means that that sidebar would disappear and my content would extend the full width of my page. So super helpful option here. Some authors may have an area down here toward the bottom that would have a layout type of selection. So you could choose that. And again, it would create that sort of full width page template. You'll have all sorts of really cool options in here. Sometimes they have an archive option where if you wanted all of your posts from your blog to display on one page, it'll give that sort of structure. So depending upon how creative your author got. And then the last thing is you want to set up your footer area. A lot of people forget that you have the opportunity to create a really dynamic footer that gives your user a really great user experience. So in order to do that, you'll want to go to your appearance and go to your widgets area, right? And this again is going to look a little different depending upon theme to theme, but you're looking for something over here on the right side called footer areas. And you would have some opportunities to drop in content. Any of these, as you know, on this column here, these are available widgets that you can drag and drop into these boxes and use them in that allotted space. Okay, so again, like I shared with you, it might be a variation of kind of these steps that I've given you here today, but always, always look for that documentation and look for that forum that author might have for you, all right? If you have questions though, specifically about your WordPress theme, we also want to be a resource for you, as well as your local meetup group for WordPress. So be sure to Google around in your area or give us a tweet. I'll put our contact information in the description box below. We'll see you next week for WordPress Wednesday. Bye-bye, y'all.
Hey, everybody. Videos are a great resource for learning, but there's nothing better than learning in person from WordPress experts. We offer a beginner's course and an advanced track that can teach you everything you want to know about WordPress. Our classes start soon, so head over to WebTegrity.com and register today.